I had never thought about that question. I decided to make this film for quite different reasons. I wanted to do something light. I wanted to do comedy. And I had 20,000 feet, which I had nearly 7,000 meters of old film stock that I wanted to use that was no good for anything else. One's environment has an influence on oneself. And it has something to do with character, not so much character, but the way characters behave. You put the fanatic from the tracker in an office, and he would behave very differently. I'm not sure how that connects with inside or outside. Okay. I think what is worth saying is that sort of analysis comes from viewers. Mm-hmm. I don't make that analysis when I do the films. Do I have a connection? I think I go about it very differently. I've seen Burden of Dreams, and my approach is very different. In terms of the connection of the work, that is a better judgment made by other people. There is almost no music in Ten Canoes, but Dr. Plonk is nothing but music. Yes, music is incredibly important. It depends on the film how exactly it is important. Sometimes it's very on the surface for reasons that are to do with the film. Sometimes you don't notice the music at all, but it's there working. Sometimes it's very precise, and sometimes some sections of the film are very precise, but mostly sometimes a film has to be made very precisely, and at other times it can be very open and free and a big exploration with the actors. Yes, sometimes I've cast non-professional actors because I sense something about that they can improvise. In Bad Boy Mummy, there are some people cast particularly for their improvisational ability, even though they had not done any acting. In Dr. Plonk, the lead actor is not a professional actor, but he's a street performer, and in the physical comedy, he could improvise. I have plans not to make another film for a while. I've done 5 in a row, one after another after another, and I need to stop I need to live life for a bit. I need to understand living.
I see.